Before I go into the aspect that is scapegoating, I want to go into the objective perspective, the centralized, steel swan says. And I want to look at both aspects visually. How are they looking to me? How are they feeling? All of that stuff. When I'm feeling into and looking at the aspect that is the scapegoat, I feel like I'm looking at before it was a 5-year-old boy, now it's like an adult. It's like maybe 18. Feels like the age 18. Feels angry, like I'm not gonna fucking take it anymore. That energy. Feels like it's more in its power, more aware now. A lot less tendency of sitting back as opposed to like really taking control over and recognizing that it's like the rage, the anger is that aspect's power, and it's not just going to sit back anymore and let this happen. And it wants to change that it's being scapegoated. Looking at the aspect that scapegoats before was this like lieutenant or colonel sitting here with this black uniform with all of these pins, wrinkly, angry face, wanting to control. It feels like the 5-year-old boy now. Actually, 5-year-old, let me see. It's more like 3-year-old. 3-year-old aspect now is what it feels like. Like younger than the 5-year-old. Wants help, needs help, needs a lot of help. There's a recognition that, this aspect really needs help and is not going to get anywhere without that help at this point in its life. Like, it really needs help. It feels sorry for being so harsh on itself. It's crying, sitting like this, crying. I feel like they've switched places in a way. That's really interesting. They've totally switched places. Okay, I'm gonna go into the aspect now of the scapegoat. I'm now gonna go back into the aspect that is scapegoating, and we're going to see further how this aspect feels, but also the aspect of the scapegoat wants to make this aspect aware that it needs to stop. So we're gonna see how that plays out. How are you feeling? Can you please tell me what I did wrong? Why am I? I feel like I'm constantly hurting myself and I'm not getting anywhere, ever. Like it's not helping at all whatsoever. Nothing that I do is helping.
Do you see how the decisions you made have hurt you?
Well, you said that I'm hurting myself and I'm hurting others. How am I hurting myself?
Doing things you don't actually want to do by taking responsibility for things you actually don't want to do because you want to. control.
But nobody else is going to do them.
Yeah.
So what does that mean? What should I do? Like, I feel like I have no power here.
Yeah.
I feel weak.
Do you feel like you don't matter?
I don't matter. How am I hurting myself?
By not listening to the parts of you that are in pain and need to be seen by others.
Those parts are in pain.
Mm-hmm.
Like a lot of pain?
A lot of pain. Yeah.
How?
They're being dragged into doing things that they don't really want to do.
But that's because, like, I can't, like, get my needs met any other way.
Yeah.
I mean, I can see how that could be hurting myself, and so, like, the part, there's, like, you're telling me, like, there's a part of me that feels like it's, like, I'm being cruel to it?
Mm-hmm.
How?
Demanding that it needs to be in line when you feel like you're out of control. You're demanding.
I am out of control. I, like, the truth is, I just need to get my needs met.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And I can't do that on my own.
Yeah.
So I want to make somebody else responsible.
Yeah.
Like, they're the reason why I'm not.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
That's what I prefer to do.
Yeah. It's like a
I just can't take it. I can't take it. I can't take any more responsibility on me. What do I do then? Just stop taking responsibility?
No, we have to find others. We have to reach out.
So finding others is taking responsibility?
Yes.
And so, like, you're saying that if I find others, then I don't have to put that responsibility on someone who doesn't want to do it?
Mm-hmm.
Do you think I'm putting that responsibility on myself? And I don't want to do it. I know I don't want to do it. I can't do it anymore.
Yes.
I can't.
Yes. Yes.
How do I find some of them?
By putting yourself out there and letting everyone see your pain for how it really is.
I feel like, is it more than just pain though?
Grief.
But is it anger?
Anger, rage, all of it.
I feel like there's a part of me that's angry with myself.
Yeah.
Like, that part is angry.
Mm-hmm. It's really mad. It really feels like you're not listening to me.
I'm sorry. Like, I'm really sorry. I know, you know, like, I'm sorry.
Mm-hmm.
I've been making you, a victim. I've been putting this all on you. Me saying I don't want to do any of it. Let me hand all of this load to you, put it on you, make you the problem. I feel like I genuinely need to say that I only did that because I felt like I couldn't get my needs met. So I coped with that pain by putting it on somebody else and making them the reason.
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
Yeah.
I know you probably hate me. And now that I'm aware that you are hurting like this, and I can feel it in myself, I'm gonna recognize if I do that again. And you can show me, and I'll understand. I feel like instead of me putting the responsibility on you, instead of me making you the reason for all of my pain, I need to just stop. Stop doing so much. Stop pushing myself. Stop giving everything to the point that I am at a deficit. And if I really want to take responsibility, that means finding others who want to meet my needs. I'm actually scared of that. I'm feeling that I'm actually scared of that.
Yeah.
Like, if I find somebody who actually wants to meet my needs, people that want to meet my needs, and there are a lot of them, there are a lot of needs that I have, I can tell you. Do you, I mean, it looks like me basically doing nothing except for things that I want to do, but no chores. Somebody cooks my food, somebody cleans up after me, somebody does my laundry, somebody buys my groceries, somebody pays my rent, somebody pays my utilities, provides for me all the stuff I didn't get that I was supposed to get. And just because I was capable doesn't mean I should have never been doing any of that stuff. And now I'm pushing me and others, I'm pushing myself so much to do these things. And there is a part that just I'm now seeing that is really hurting. I have to stop this. I feel like I have an option. I feel like if I choose to focus on finding people or putting myself out there, like you said, like sharing my pain and anger, because that's a part of me, like sharing the angry part of me that never got what I wanted, and sharing my grief for never getting what I wanted. I might just get what I want. I just see and hear a crying baby that wants to be held.
Mm-hmm.
That's the part I've been trying to protect.
Mm-hmm.
The baby crying for his mom, somebody to hold him. I have to stop doing this if I want to get it anywhere. None of it matters. I'm abusing myself. I feel like I have an option, like something I can try to just put myself out there, and I might actually get one. It's hard to believe that there are people who exist out there that actually want to give me this thing that I need. Does that exist?
Mm-hmm. You've been told to believe that there is nobody that can help you.
But it exists.
But it exists, yes.
There are people who actually want to help me.
Yes.
And want to give.
Yes.
So that I can receive.
Mm-hmm. They're more than willing
and
to
And they
give.
Want to be received.
Yes.
Okay. Okay. You promise me?
I promise you.
I feel like I have to say I'm really sorry to myself for hurting myself for so long and pushing that part of me away and hurting that part of me. For hurting me. That part now feels like it's me. Mm-hmm. It doesn't even feel separate. You don't have to be the scapegoat anymore. Because I'm going to take responsibility. I'm going to show people my pain, my reality. And find somebody who wants to give to me so that I can receive and they can be received. I feel like that part of me has something to say.
Yeah, let's talk to me.
I feel like somebody sees me for who I actually am.
Yeah.
And that's powerful.
Mm-hmm.
I'm powerful.
Yes.
And I don't have to be weak to get what I want. Yes. I don't have to give up one part of myself. I don't have to give up my safety. To get some other level of safety, to be comforted, I can be me,
mm-hmm.
without having to be sorry.
Mm-hmm.
I can actually be me. There's nothing wrong with me.
Yeah, there's nothing wrong with you.
There never was.
There never was.
I'm not going to be targeted anymore.
You're not going to be targeted.
You're anymore. Sure that, like, the promises?
I promise. This part is aware that what it had been doing to you is wrong. And they're going to consider and take into account.
Okay, I can feel that. I can feel it in myself. I can feel that there's a promise there.
Mm-hmm.
Back in the objective, the central eye, I can feel that these aspects have integrated with me. And I feel special. Like, unique. I feel like I'm gonna be cared for. Like it's my time. Like it's my time to get what I want, to get what I need. And there's nothing in my way. Except the need to, I have to take action. I can't just sit here. It's not gonna just come to me. I have to take action. I have to put myself out there. I have to share like the vulnerability in me, the part that's like really upset, really fucking frustrated, angry, and resentful for not getting what I needed in childhood. And like the extreme level of grief that's associated with that as well. feel like I feel like I was both of these parts, but at the same time, like, I was neither. I can feel the part, I can feel that they were protecting. A vulnerable aspect was a crying baby. I can feel that part in me so much now. Needing to be held and needing to be picked up. It's like a feeling of needing to be rescued from just being alone in a crib and left there. For hours and hours and hours. Having like this deep, deep, deep need and desire and desire. Like there's so much desire there that's going unmet. That's not being recognized actually. It's being neglected. I feel so, I can see these aspects now, and I can see why they were doing what they were doing, because I would want to protect this part too, and I did. It makes me feel like grateful that these parts were there protecting me in their own way, and I'm grateful. More grateful the fact that they see me now. I feel like in this central eye, I actually feel like I am a vulnerable aspect. And I feel like I wasn't even aware that they were there. Feel like they weren't, I didn't even know that they were there protecting me at all, whatsoever. I didn't know that. I just felt alone the entire time. Which, makes me feel two things, or makes me recognize two things. One being the truth was that I was alone as the baby in my crib, being neglected. And the other truth is that I'm not alone. Because I can see that these parts were there protecting me, like throughout my life now. Because they saw me as being so special and unique and needing protection, like sacred. Feeling that feels like somebody would want to actually meet my needs for once in my life. Like there's actually hope for me. Which means there's hope for everybody. I feel so grateful. Going to be taken care of after like 30 years. There's so much pain there There's so much gratitude, but 30 years, wow, it's a long time of having to really try and having to really be victimized to get a sliver of what I wanted, what I actually wanted. You are not powerless. This is the truth, and you can see that here, and I can feel that, and I'm sure you can too. Thank you for watching.